you seen him since I've seen you last? Is he in the room now? With the recent remodeling of the office, I first would like to thank you for agreeing to meet in my home. I hope I've made everything as comfortable as possible. But any further ado, will you please try to explain to the best of your ability what exactly you've been seeing?
Well, he's always wearing the same attire. He's always in a gray suit, a white undershirt, and he only appears at night.
So, our previous visit, I prescribed chlorpromazine, which is an antipsychotic at 40 milligrams, and you've been having no betterment. You've still been seeing this thing the same amount of time? Okay, will you explain, give me the ambiance, take me there, what exactly are you seeing? What are you doing when you're seeing this thing for me to help you better?
Well, it's not always consistent at when he appears, but he chooses when to appear, and he chooses when he decides to disappear, and it's never consistent. It's always like he's there and then he's not, or he's there for a long time and then he's not there. It's really hard to predict when he shows up.
Again, take me through a typical day, or what exactly you would be doing, or hearing, or even seeing or thinking about when you see this thing.
It would be like, for instance, if Harley would be taking the trash out, he would just be there, just standing there at the end of the gate, and he just doesn't move, he's just there. And then, like, sometimes I go inside and it's like he disappears. But then, like, other times I'll go inside, he's sitting there at the counter.
Have you ever exchanged any communication with him?
No, it's when I see him, it's like I'm petrified. I can only move, I can't speak or think straight.
I've been losing sleep, a lot of sleep recently, because he just stands at the foot of my bed, and it's always he's here right now.
There's no one here.
But he is here. He's right here. He's right there.
Sir, have you been taking any controlled substances?
No, I've only been taking the prescription you prescribed, and I still see him. He's standing right there.
How many psychologists have you been to? I'm trying my best here.
And I understand that, but he's still here. He is literally right there.
Do you feel like you're in danger?
I don't know what to feel. It's just some dude looking like Santa in a suit just over me.
Wait, hold on. What do you mean looking like Santa?
It's a dude in a gray suit and a white undershirt, and he has a Santa head, and he constantly is watching me. And I don't know what to do. The meds don't work, and I'm freaking out.
Because... So... I'm just trying to rationalize what you're seeing. Do you think this thing has any malintentions to you?
I don't know, because he doesn't talk. He just stands there. It's just like a figure, just like an empty shell of a person. But it's not a person, it's definitely, I don't know what the hell it is.
Well, I definitely think what you're experiencing is real to you. However, this is something that I don't think medication alone can treat, and we might have to consider inpatient psychotherapy.
What would that entail? So is it like an asylum?
I wouldn't use the word asylum in the way you're thinking of. Since the 50s, we've come a long way in inpatient care.
Yeah, but I'm not being locked up away in some room just to myself. It'll just be like in the house.
No, it's not what you're thinking. I truly believe that this is what would be best for you, and you'll be safe.
No, I'm sorry.
Yeah, no. I'm sorry. I'm definitely not doing that. Thank you for your time, doctor, but this session is over.
I truly think it would be beneficial
for
you
to... No, I'm sorry. I'm not getting locked up.
Sir, I really do.
Thank you for your time, and thank you for your advice, but I'm sorry. I can't do that. No. Thank you. Bye.
You're not fucking real.
Darkness falls across the land. The midnight hour is close at hand. Creatures crawl in search of blood to terrorize y'all's neighborhood. And whosoever shall be found without the soul for getting down must stand and face the hounds of hell and rot inside a corpse's shell. The foulest stenches in the air, the funk of 40,000 years, and grisly ghouls from every tomb are closing in to seal your doom. And though you fight to stay alive, your body starts to shiver, for no mere mortal can resist the evil of the thriller.